This video will show you what the difference is between files and folders in Scrivener, how files and folders can help you structure your project so you can always keep track of your documents, and how you can use files and folders to your advantage for quick and easy exporting. I'm using version 2.7 on the Mac. Alright, let's jump into it. Hi everyone, this is Béla from the Writer's Territory. As you may already know, Scrivener's binder can hold files as well as folders. The concept of a folder as we know it usually is to hold files. For example, in your Finder, you might have a folder that holds several of your scripts or other documents. In Scrivener, the concept of a folder is somewhat different. What does that mean? In Scrivener, files and folders are basically the same thing. So, in order to look at what folders can do in Scrivener, let's have a look at files first. What can you do with your Scrivener files? They can hold content, they can hold subdocuments, you can split them, and you can combine them. Since in Scrivener, files and folders are the same thing, you can do all of that with folders as well. You can even change a file to a folder and back without losing any information. Let's test that. I have a Scrivener project here that contains multiple folders with multiple documents and subdocuments. This project is based on the novel project template. I just added some folders and documents with our beloved lorem ipsum. Now I'm going to change all those files into folders and see what happens. Nothing at all. As you can see, folders can hold content as well as files can. When a folder holds content by itself, you see this little text icon appear in the bottom right corner. And if I want, I can easily change the folders back into files. So if files and folders are basically the same, what do I need folders for at all? There is a small difference in the way Scrivener displays files and folders. If you click on a file that holds subdocuments but also content by itself, like this one, Scrivener will automatically show you the contents of this document and not the contents of its subdocuments. To see the contents of the subdocuments, you'll have to activate Scrivening View Mode. If you click on a folder that holds subdocuments as well as content, Scrivener will show you its subdocuments in Scrivening mode by default, but not its own folder content. In order to see its content, you have to disable Scrivening View mode. And there is another difference. If you open the compile dialog, you'll see that you can use different compile settings for folders, files with subdocuments, and files without subdocuments. This means you can structure your project in a way that enables you to make use of different compile settings for files and folders. This novel project template is a good example. You can use your folders for the chapter titles of your book and then use different compile settings to format the chapter contents in your files. Whatever the special demands of your project hierarchy might be, using files and folders in Scrivener interchangeably gives you a whole lot of freedom and flexibility for writing and compiling your work. If you liked this video, please subscribe to the free Writer's Territory newsletter. Let me help you decide which is the best writing software for you before you spend your money, and let me show you how you can use the software you already own to your best advantage. Don't miss regular news updates, reviews, how-tos, and tips and tricks about the best software for writers like you.